Sedona at Sedona Candle Magic, so let's go see how some candles are made.
Hi. So we keep this wax at 160, guys, and that'll keep the layers that I'm adding paper thin. So when I do the carving, you'll be left with the cool glowing effect. So that's what the lights around the room are for. These initial layers are what we call the glow effect. So all this pink will be shining through any of the colors that I add later on. Blowing on the wax adds a little bit of texture. A little bit of white wax. And then we'll go into this blue here. Clear wax, we have to let these wet layers cool down a little bit, and then we'll add even more wax to it, and that's when the carving process will take place. The reason why these inside layers need to be cold is because the outside layers that I add next need to be hotter so it'll peel off of the cold layer. But since we have someone videotaping, we'll speed up the process a little bit. We'll go into this water, dip it a couple of times. I really like the marbleizing right here, so I'm just going to do a little trick. I'm going to use this piece of wax to mark the top, so when I do that other carvings, I'll know exactly what's inside of the candle. So my plan for this candle is we're going to have a coyote scene. They'll be howling at a moon. You just freehand or?
Yeah, everything's freehand. So all the designs you see around the room, we have to carve in 8 to 10 minutes. And that's solely because when we're done dipping the candle, the wax is cooling down.
You have to practice.
A little bit of practice.
So how long do you have?
You get like no more than 10 minutes. So usually go with her mold. There's no way to repeat it.
So we're working on the outside colors for the candle. Candle dance. These drippings are the first thing to go. It's a nice little squishy wax for you to play with.
There's a chocolate store, definitely, if you continue up these stairs. There you go, on the other side of the stairs. Stay left, and we're
Yeah. This will mark the top where the burning wax will be taking place. Keeps the design from interfering with it.
That's the one that has the like Mackinac Island restaurant. That one's across the street from the other one.
Okay. All right. Perfect. We'll get one. Both of them. Thank you. Yeah.
Daddy,
yes.
Daddy,
yes.
Yes. I saw this one.
Did you?
Got the coyote in there, and now I'm putting some cactus around him.
I'm gonna do a water run. Does anybody need that?
I'm good.
Awesome. I am all good. Thank you.
Okay.
So here's that peeling process. So these outer layers are a lot hotter than the inside, so it won't stick to it. About six layers of wax there.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna switch tools. This is a router tool. This will scrape away the wax. Couple swirls on the back. So I'll use this white scrap to do a little crescent moon for the sky. And we can use the wax as an adhesive, so I'm just gonna dip the backside in the clear and just stick it right to the candle. So now that all of our design work is out of the way, we're gonna dip it in the clear wax and that'll seal up everything so nothing pops off later. So that reveals the core of the candle, and now we can try out the glow.
That is awesome.
I'm gonna add stars. So this fancy little pin here, we'll just poke some holes, and that allows the light to shine through white. Gives the illusion of a night sky.
That is awesome.
Thanks, thank guys.
You. You're welcome.
Should we try one out?
Definitely.
Should we try one out?
Sure.